Dear students, today we will discuss about proteins. So in this topic we are going to study about amino acids, their structure, configuration, classification. We will discuss about peptides and polypeptides, different structures of proteins and denaturation of proteins. So let's start proteins. Proteins are the most abundant biomolecules of the living system. Chief sources of proteins are milk, cheese, pulses, peanuts, fish, meat, etc. They occur in every part of the body and form the fundamental basis of structure and functions of life. They are also required for growth and maintenance of body. The word protein is derived from Greek word proteos, which means primary or of prime importance. Proteins compounds possess very high molecular mass, approximately 20,000 to 2 crore. They are biopolymer complexes of amino acids. They are present in all living cells. Therefore, proteins are of prime physiological importance in all living cells. Enzymes, hormones, antibodies are all proteins. A large number of different amino acids are obtained by the hydrolysis of protein. All protein contains carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen elements, while some may also contain non-metal like sulfur, phosphorus and metal elements like iron, copper, zinc and manganese in trace of amount. Take care, जब आपको पूछा जाए कि विच एलिमेंट्स आर प्रेजेंट इन अमीनो एसिड्स, तो दिस कैन बी कार्बन, हाइड्रोजन, ऑक्सीजन, नाइट्रोजन, अलोंग विद दैट अदर नॉन मेटल्स लाइक सल्फर एंड फॉस्फरस एंड मेटल एलिमेंट्स इन ट्रेस ऑफ अमाउंट लाइक आयरन, कॉपर, जिंक एंड मैंगनीज. अब कभी ऐसा पूछ लिया जाए कि विच नॉन मेटल्स आर प्रेजेंट, तो स्टूडेंट्स सिर्फ सल्फर और फॉस्फरस लिख कर आते हैं एंड दैट इज़ नॉट करेक्ट. कार्बन, हाइड्रोजन, ऑक्सीजन, नाइट्रोजन भी नॉन मेटल्स ही है. So there are 4 + 2 = 6 non-metals. You should be careful. Proteins on hydrolysis initially gives peptides. Peptides on further hydrolysis gives amino acids. Now we will understand what amino acids are, what are their structures, what are the classification and configurations. In 1901, scientist Emil Fischer had obtained several amino acids by hydrolysis of proteins. Thus, amino acids are the building blocks of protein structure. The name amino acid indicates that they contain both an amino NH2 and carboxyl COOH groups. Those amino acids which are obtained from hydrolysis of proteins are all alpha amino acids. This means that in their structure, amino group is on alpha carbon atom adjacent to carboxyl group. Means what? It is on the same carbon atom to which COOH is also joined. It is necessary to study amino acids before studying the proteins and peptides. You can see the general structure of amino acid. RCH NH2 COOH. COOH जिस कार्बन पर है उसी कार्बन पर NH2 है तो उसे अल्फा अमीनो एसिड कहेंगे. उसके बगल वाले कार्बन पर है तो उसे बीटा, उसके बाजू में है तो गामा, उसके बाजू में है तो डेल्टा. ऐसे अल्फा, बीटा, गामा, डेल्टा, उस तरह के डिफरेंट अमीनो एसिड्स एग्जिस्ट करते हैं, लेकिन हमारे लिए जो फिजियोलॉजिकली इंपॉर्टेंट है वो अल्फा अमीनो एसिड है. यहाँ जो R दिखाया गया है वो वेरिएबल ग्रुप्स है, उस वेरिएबल ग्रुप्स के हिसाब से डिफरेंट डिफरेंट अमीनो एसिड्स एग्जिस्ट करते हैं. इफ आर की वैल्यू एच है तो उसे ग्लाइसिन अमीनो एसिड कहेंगे. दैट इज द ओनली अमीनो एसिड विच इज ऑप्टिकली इनएक्टिव. अदर देन दैट इफ यू टेक डिफरेंट आर वैल्यूज ऑल अमीनो एसिड्स आर ऑप्टिकली एक्टिव. Here R is not restricted to alkyl group. R may be open chain, cyclic or aromatic hydrocarbon group, amino, carboxyl, hydroxyl or sulfur containing groups also. It is necessary to note here that structure of all alpha amino acids possess primary amino group, while only one, that is a proline, you will have to be careful about this proline structure. Only proline contains a secondary amino group. In this compound, nitrogen atom of amino group is involved in five-membered ring. So only proline is such which has a secondary amino group, while rest all are such they have primary amino group. All alpha amino acids are known by their trivial names. From these names, general properties or their sources can be known, but no information can be obtained about their structures. Glycine got its name because of its sweet taste. In Greek, glycos meaning sweets. Tyrosine got its name because it was first obtained from cheese. In Greek, tyros means cheese. As we know that amino acid contains one acidic group COOH and one basic group NH2, therefore acidic, basic and neutral nature of amino acids depends on the nature of attaching group R. Amino acids can be further classified as neutral, acidic and basic amino acids as follows. Neutral amino acids. The amino acid which has equal number of amino and COOH groups is known as neutral amino acid, and the example is glycine and alanine. Acidic amino acid. The amino acid which has more number of carboxylic group as compared to amino group is known as acidic amino acid, and the examples are aspartic acid and glutamic acid. Name itself suggests that it is acidic in nature. Basic amino acid. Amino acid which has more number of amino groups than carboxyl group is known as basic amino acid. Examples are lysine and arginine. You will have to remember all these examples. Essential and non-essential amino acids. Amino acids which can be synthesized in body are known as non-essential amino acids, and those which cannot be synthesized in the body and must be obtained through diet are called essential amino acids. Leucine, isoleucine, lysine, methionine, phenylalanine, threonine, tryptophan, valine, arginine and histidine are essential amino acids. So you should remember all these names. Once again, leucine, isoleucine, lysine, methionine, phenylalanine, threonine, tryptophan, valine, arginine and histidine are essential amino acids. D and L forms of amino acids. We can say that in all amino acids, alpha carbon is chiral carbon except glycine. Therefore, D and L forms of all these amino acids can exist. You can see in the structure, D amino acid and L amino acids are there. NH2, which is the most priority group, if existing on the right hand side in the Fischer structure, it will be called D configuration, and the mirror image of that in which it exists on the left hand side, it is called L amino acid. The Fischer projection of amino acid with COOH group on the top and the R group at the bottom of the vertical axis is a D amino acid if the NH2 group is on the right hand side of the horizontal axis, and is a L amino acid if NH2 is on the left hand side. Most of the amino acids found in nature have L configuration. Amino acid as dipolar molecule. Amino acids are usually colorless crystalline solids. These are water soluble, high melting solids and behave like salts rather than simple amines or carboxylic acid. Now looking at the formula, you can see its formula, structural formula is RCHNH2 and COOH, right? Now looking at the formula, you can see that it is simple covalent molecule, and if it is a simple covalent molecule, it should not have high melting point, and if this R increases, we know that the solubility in water gradually decreases, but all these irrespective of the molecular weight, they are soluble in water. That suggests that it should exist in some salt formation. This behavior is due to the presence of both acidic carboxylic group and basic amino group in the same molecule. In aqueous solution, the carboxylic group can lose a proton and amino group can accept a proton, giving rise to a dipolar ion which is known as Zwitter ion. This is neutral but contains both positive and negative charges. In Zwitter ionic form, amino acids show amphoteric behavior as they react both with acids as well as bases. You can see RCH, COOH and NH2. Now, this nitrogen has lone pair of electron on it and this hydrogen is acidic in nature, so this is releasing hydrogen and this accepts hydrogen and converts into NH3+. So this is how this exists as a negative as well as positive both in the same molecule. That's why it is Zwitter ion, known as Zwitter ion, or it is also called bipolar ion. If solution of amino acid is put in an electric field, then the ions present will migrate towards the specific electrode depending upon the charge they have. If amino acid is present as negative ion in its solution, then it will migrate towards anode, that is positive electrode, and if amino acid is present as positive ion in its solution, then it will migrate towards cathode, that is negative ion, negative electrode. If amino acid is a dipolar ion in its solution, then it will not migrate towards anode or cathode because of dipolar ion is neutral in nature with respect to balancing of charge. So agar wo neutral hai to wo kahin par bhi migrate nahi karega, lekin agar wo positively charged hai to wo cathode ki taraf travel karega, negatively charged hai to wo anode ki taraf travel karega. In electric field, the pH value at which the amino acid does not migrate towards any electrode is called isoelectric point of amino acid, denoted as pI. So we have to maintain the pH in such a way that the migration of that amino acid will stop towards any of the electrode. That is called what? That is called isoelectric point. Different amino acids have different isoelectric points. Most of the amino acids react with acid or base and form salt, so they are known as amphoteric compounds. A mixture of amino acids can be separated by, this is very important, this can be separated by electrophoresis and different chromatographic techniques. So you should remember this. So electrophoresis and chromatographic techniques se wo alag kiye jaate hai. Now we can see this dipolar ion, that is RCHNA3+ and RCOO-, in acidic solution what happens, this COO- will accept H+ and it will become RCOOH neutral part, so these will exist as a positive ion. Now to this solution if you add OH-, these OH- will once again take away this H+, so it will again be converted into dipolar ion. लेकिन यही डाइपोलर आयन अगर बेसिक मीडियम में है तो क्या होगा, ये OH- यहां से प्रोटॉन खींच लेगा तो ये Na3+ न्यूट्रल बन जाएगा NH2 लाइक दिस एंड दिस COO- विल रिमेन एज सच. सो दिस COO- विल मेक द नेगेटिव आयन. और वही सॉल्यूशन को अगर हम फिर से एसिडिक कर देंगे तो क्या होगा, रिएक्शन रिवर्स जाएगी, दिस H+ विल बी added to this NH2 and it will become again Na3+ as dipolar ion. So in acidic medium it exists as positive ion and in basic medium it exists as negative ion. Thus amino acid exists as positive ion in acidic medium, means pH less than 7, negative ion pH greater than 7 basic medium, or dipolar ion when the pH is 7, that is neutral. This everything depends upon the pH of the aqueous solution, ke wo acidic bhi hai, sorry, wo anionic form mein hoga ya cationic form mein hoga ya dipolar ion ke form mein